What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Ray Talks Hoop. Today, we're going to be talking about why the Toronto Raptors are fighting an uphill battle. But first and foremost, let me make it clear that just because I'm saying that a team is fighting an uphill battle, that doesn't necessarily mean that that is a bad thing. Quite the contrary, actually. Good things come out of fighting uphill battles. For instance, in last year's playoffs, we saw the Denver Nuggets were down 3-1 to the team whose name I don't even like to mention because they are a disgrace to my Lakers. The Denver Nuggets ended up fighting hard, and what came out of that? They ended up bouncing the out of the playoffs. So why do I bother mentioning that, and what exactly does that have to do with the Toronto Raptors? You see, at the start of the season, the Toronto Raptors were the 14th seed in the NBA. Now, a lot of this had to do with them being in Tampa as opposed to Toronto. Some of you might not think it's a big deal, but when you're a professional athlete and you don't have your own bed, your own house, your own area to live in, you are living in a different country. Meanwhile, the people you're playing against still are living in their mansions, they still have their chef, they still have their rooms. LeBron James is still getting his weekly massages. Yeah, you're gonna be at a disadvantage when you're playing these guys. And that's not even including that the Raptors were having a lot of defensive issues. The defense in the paint was way worse at the start of the season than what it is right now. Pascal Siakam was still in a slump offensively. He had multiple games where he only scored single-digit points. The Raptors have really been lacking at the center position. And overall, it just was not a good start to the season for the Toronto Raptors. But in typical Toronto Raptor fashion, they somehow managed to figure it out once again. So what has happened since then, and how are the Raptors beating this uphill climb that they're going on? Well, fast forward to around middle of January, the Raptors went on a 3-game win streak. And at the end of this 3-game win streak, they were ranked the 9th seed in the conference. Then, fast forward to last week, the Raptors beat the Brooklyn Nets, and that sealed another 3-game win streak. When the Raptors beat the Nets, they were officially the 7th seed in the Eastern Conference. But unfortunately, that seeding did not last very long because the very next morning, the New York Knicks played the Portland Trail Blazers. And when the Knicks beat the Blazers, that put them a game or a game and a half, somewhere in the ballpark of one game. But they were a game or so ahead of the Toronto Raptors. And because of that, the Raptors went from being the 7th seed to the 8th seed. Now, at the time, the Raptors and the Hawks had the exact same record of 10 wins and 12 losses. So the Hawks had the 7th seed and the Raptors had the 8th. And ironically, that very same day, the Hawks and the Raptors were scheduled to play one another. And that was a must-win game for both teams because essentially, whoever lost was going to fall down a bit in the rankings. And unfortunately for the Toronto Raptors, they ended up losing that game to the Atlanta Hawks. So when this happened, the Raptors fell from being the 8th seed to being the 9th seed, despite having been the 7th seed a couple days before. And now all of this leads us to yesterday, because once again, the Raptors are the 8th seed. And this all came after beating the Memphis Grizzlies last night. And I've been making videos on the Raptors and other teams just documenting their progress throughout the season. So if you want to stay in the loop on everything going on with your team, please go ahead and give this video a like and hit that subscribe button as well. But here's the funny part. When the Raptors were the 14th seed, I made a video saying that if you are a Raptors fan, you do not have to be worried. Because despite being the 14th seed, the fundamentals of the Raptors team is good enough to get them out of that slump. And when the Raptors jumped up to being the 9th seed, I made another video basically saying that my prediction was right. And now, I'm doubling down on everything I said, and here's why. Sure, the Raptors might be the 8th seed right now, which is certainly a step up from being the 14th seed, but ladies and gentlemen, the Raptors only have one less win than the number 4th seed Boston Celtics. And if you've been keeping up with Toronto basketball this season, you know that they lost 2 games this year by only 1 point. And those games were actually back-to-backs. So if they would have just won one of those games, then their seeding could look a whole lot different than what it looks right now. Now, some of you might be wondering, Ray, how is it that you were right about the Toronto Raptors? Because we're looking at the Western Conference teams, and the teams that were ranked 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th at the start of the season, for the most part, the majority of those teams are still bottom feeder teams. So how is it that I was able to look at the Toronto Raptors back when they still had a bad record and say, you know what, out of all the teams with a poor record right now, this is the one who I think is going to be a good team? The answer to that question is really quite simple. You see, the Toronto Raptors do not have a set superstar. They don't have a LeBron, they don't have a Kevin Durant or any of those guys, but they have something that is actually better. They have a real basketball team. Kyle Lowry, if you ask most Toronto Raptor fans, they will say that he is the heart and soul of the Raptors. What happened yesterday? He had back spasms, unfortunately, and left the game after only having played 8 minutes. For most teams, if their star player leaves the game, that team probably isn't gonna win the game. But that's not the case with the Toronto Raptors. Kyle Lowry left the game yesterday, and Pascal Siakam stepped it up. Siakam had 32 on 11 of 18, and props to him. The last 4, 5, 6 games, this guy has been playing very well. Fred VanVleet, the guy who went undrafted, the guy who people were saying Kawhi Leonard carried in the playoffs. This guy also stepped it up. He had 32 points, 9 assists on 8 of 14 from the field. And then Norman Powell had 29 on 10 of 17. And that's not even including the fact that Nick Nurse, their head coach, was ejected. So why do I think the Raptors are going to be a very good team? They have a bunch of assets that can really get the job done. Chris Boucher might win the most improved player. Norman Powell and OG have proven to be very valuable assets to that team. Now, the one thing I think the Raptors could still improve on is the center position. If they could manage to get a decent center on their team, that would be the game changer for them. But those are the reasons why I think the Raptors are fighting an uphill battle. And if you made it this far into the video, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It helps out the channel tremendously. And hit that subscribe button down below as well. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Once again, I'll see you guys tomorrow. I am out of here.